Most of the time, data coming from IoT devices needs to be enriched with metadata from other data sources or some context. Ashita is here to tell us everything about the new feature in IoT Hub called the message enrichment today on the IoT Show. Hi everyone, thanks for watching the IoT Show. I'm Olivier, your host, and we have Ashita with us to talk about Azure IoT Hub message enrichments. Ashita, thanks for joining the show again.
Thank you, Olivier. How are you?
Fine, awesome. Great. So, for those who have not seen the previous episode, shame on you. You should go and watch it. Can you introduce yourself and what your team is doing within Microsoft and the Azure group?
Sure. I'm Ashita Rastogi. I'm a PM in the Azure IoT Hub team. And I focus on data integration features, so making it easy for our customers to connect their devices and make the data flow into Azure or their own business applications.
So Azure IoT Hub is our gateway for devices. Mm-hmm. And when we published it first, it was doing basic things, allowing to securely connect devices and ingest telemetry messages from these devices, as you would expect.
Yeah.
But as our customers are using Azure IoT Hub, they're asking for more features.
Yeah.
And this new feature you're here to talk to us about is about adding or stamping, mm-hmm. you know, these messages are coming in for what purpose?
Yeah. So we have a lot of customers who are ingesting data into a single endpoint from many devices and mm-hmm. many different IoT hubs. And they want to know what IoT Hub actually send this information, or they want to know what device when tag was used on this so that it's easy for them to post-process this mm-hmm. using that information.
So hence the enrichment name, right? You enrich
yes.
the telemetry data and the metadata contained into the message mm-hmm. envelope or body
yeah.
with, and we'll see in details exactly yeah. what that means, with that metadata coming from other sources or from another reference.
Right, exactly. So it's a very simple configuration to do, mm-hmm. and all you need is basically what is the key value for the enrichment, what's the key, and then what's the value for the enrichment, and okay. what endpoint it needs to be applied to. So all the data going to that endpoint will be stamped with the same information.
Awesome. Well, let's look a little bit into your diagram here.
Yeah.
What is the very slight differences and what's applied where? You were saying like that the metadata will be stamped depending on the endpoint your data is going to.
Yeah.
So tell us a bit more about that.
Sure. So just to revise a little bit about IoT Hub, whenever you deploy an IoT Hub, mm-hmm. the customers get a free built-in Event Hub endpoint.
Yeah.
And in addition to that, you can also configure some custom endpoints like Event Hub, Service Bus Topic, Service Bus Queue, or a storage blob. Mm-hmm. And we have message routing as a feature that allows you to configure routes to send data to these custom endpoints.
Okay. Enrichment. Quick question on that one. Actually, I got the question very often. I think it's great to clarify each time we talk about routing. Is it an either or can you actually decide that the same message from specific device goes to different endpoints depending on what you want to do with that data?
You can send the same message to the same endpoints or different endpoints. So it's not a unique message going to unique endpoints. If you want that okay. same event message to go to different endpoints, you can configure routes.
Okay, so you can configure route to do an or, not just an if.
That's right, okay. yes. And it all depends on what routing query you're using mm-hmm. in the route that you create to that endpoint.
Okay. Got it. Makes sense?
Yeah. So message enrichments can be applied to not just the events you're routing to custom endpoints, but mm-hmm. also to the built-in event hub.
Okay.
And we support adding enrichments to not just the telemetry events that yeah. are routed, but you can also add it to device twin change notifications and lifecycle events that are also data sources route supports.
Yes.
Yeah.
Love it. Seems pretty useful, actually.
Yeah.
I can think of tons of scenarios to use that. You have a little demo to show us how that works.
Yes.
Right?
Before I jump in the demo, let's talk about what an IoT Hub message looks like.
Okay.
So here we have a sample IoT Hub message mm-hmm. where on top you can see there are some system properties. These are properties that are standard on all IoT Hub messages. It's mm-hmm. an envelope that we add to the message body.
Okay.
And these are mostly populated by IoT Hub, except these two important ones, one being content type
okay.
and content encoding. We require users to add this in their device SDK mm-hmm. so that IoT Hub can understand that whether this is JSON or not.
Okay.
And in order to for users to do a query on the body on mm-hmm. the route, this must be set to JSON so that we can understand
okay.
That it's, you
okay.
know, we can parse it. And okay. the UTF-8 should be the encoding.
Makes sense. So real quick on that one. So you mentioned the fact that in our SDKs, we're mm-hmm. actually providing the all the elements for people to have these properties added in mm-hmm. the messages. Mm-hmm. If someone is using their own MQTT client or a piece of code to send messages, because people can, you know, they have to have these properties in the header of the message.
That is correct. Yes. Okay. And also, as you mentioned, in the SDK, users can define application properties, which is this group here. Yeah. And these are extremely customizable. Mm-hmm. People can say add whatever key value they want.
Yeah.
But what happens sometimes, you know, why we made enrichments is sometimes you don't know the application property that you want to apply in the SDK. It may come from the device twin or something outside of the device.
So,
and then the body is just the body of the device data. Yep. Here we have a sample where it's weather data and temperature.
Okay.
So what happens in enrichment actually is going into the application property back.
Okay.
Yeah. So in order to demo this, I'm going to do a couple of things. First is I'm going to route data to a blob store.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to configure a configure enrichments.
Okay.
And then I will use a simulated device to flow the data and see that enrichments are applied.
Pretty straightforward.
Great. So let's go ahead and add a custom endpoint, which is of type blob in my IoT hub.
And these operations you're doing while you're doing them, they can be done using the Azure CLI and the Service SDK as well, right?
Absolutely. So you can add enrichments using the IoT Hub update and create REST API using the routing properties and also using the portal.
Okay. And the portal is great for development and demos, but also in production sometimes.
Absolutely.
As well.
It makes it so easy. And notice that our data is going to be in JSON, so I'm going to click JSON as my encoding format here.
And things are working the same in Avro and JSON, right?
That is correct.
Yep.
It's just up to, you know, JSON integrates well with many other Azure services, so people want to format it that way. While this is running, we are going to go and create a route to this custom endpoint. And all we have to do is pick our existing endpoint that we just added. Now, routing supports different data sources. We have picked the telemetry.
Okay.
And we can opt to choose a query, but for simplicity, we are going to just configure.
So we're
going to
basically route everything.
Route everything, right.
Okay.
And we can always add queries. So routing actually supports querying on not just the body of the message, but also properties and also device twin.
Okay.
Now that we have that, let's look at what enrichment looks like. So we actually have this capability in preview today, and we're working on a GA soon, but you can actually apply 10 enrichments for a paid IoT Hub tier. So for basic and standard IoT Hub, you can have 10. For free, you can have 2 enrichments.
Okay.
Note that for basic IoT Hub, there is no device twin supported, so you can't add device twin. If you do, it will come out as a string path. So all I have to do here, let's say, first let me show you the device twin that I have. So what I've done is added a new device, and I use the connection string for this in my simulation. So
that
here
works.
Is my device twin. All I've done here is that I added a new property called humidity, and I set it to 68. So what I want is I don't want to, I want the value out of this device twin in my message.
In the telemetry, without having the device to have to send it.
Exactly, and without having to do the device twin calls for every device that I have. And this value can change, and I don't want to have to change and make new calls every time a twin changes. So this will automatically stamp the latest value.
Nice.
So I'm going to go in my routes again and add some enrichment. So let's say I want to call this humidity. And then all I have to do is say
I think you're missing an I in humidity.
Oh, thank you. And then I'm going to add the device twin path. So my path here is, I added it in the properties.
Yep.
And desired.humidity.
Nice.
And then I have to select what endpoint I want to apply it to. So I'm going to pick my blob.
This is where we see it's not either or. It's actually your choice of which one you want that specific enrichment to be sent to.
Applied to. Yeah. And note that all these, any enrichment added to this endpoint will, irrespective of how many routes you have, every message going to that will be stamped with the same information. So similarly, just as I explained in multi-tenant scenarios, users want to know which tenant gave what message. So some of our customers needed IoT Hub name. So let's say my IoT Hub name is or I can say tenant yep. ID, and then all you have to do is $IoT Hub name.
Okay.
And apply it. Users can also add static static strings.
So let's say you want to say something.
Right. So I'm just going to say welcome message. Yeah. And I want to add it, say welcome to the IoT show.
Nice.
And we'll just get that string.
Okay.
Hit apply. So while that is being applied, I'm going to show you my blob store. So here's a very easy way to look at the data, mm-hmm. and it's really fast. So yep. in my blob store, I actually have my IoT Hubs folder.
Yep.
And this is basically a hierarchy of the date and the file name that mm-hmm. we gave for the blob. And today being the 30th, I'm going to look into my data folder. And here's some data routed before applying enrichment. So
okay.
you can see that this is actually the application properties. So it's pretty
okay.
empty. Status pretty is empty. The only thing we have.
Yep.
And then these are our system properties mm-hmm. until this point. And these were standard that we have. I want to make sure that my content type and encoding are correct. And then
yep.
the body had weather and temperature
okay.
and location Seattle. So what we're going to do now is run this simulation. So here's a device, a mm-hmm. simulated device. Again, I have my system properties set up. I
yep.
have my JSON body here with weather and temperature. I also have location. I'm
okay.
just going to hit run. And
so we don't see any humidity command in there, and we don't see the message, and it's just a temperature sensor.
That is correct.
Data is coming.
Yes,
yep.
and humidity is going to come from
yep.
the twin. So I'm just running this once every 5 seconds,
okay.
and I'm expecting this to show me new data file in a few minutes. So another thing about enrichments is that you can also apply enrichments to data going to EventGrid. So we
okay.
just launched device telemetry going to EventGrid,
yeah.
and you can stamp information. This is very useful because you don't have device run information, you know,
from
once data is out of IoT Hub.
Yeah, got
so
it.
So prevents doing those calls.
Hence the stamping
yes.
notion that you have
absolutely.
In there. It just like stamp with whatever notion
yeah.
or metadata you need, right? Yeah, I like it.
So let's refresh this. All right, so we are looking for new information in our blob. And
mm-hmm.
here there's a new folder now. And just let's look at what data is in there. So here you will notice that my properties now has humidity, a tenant ID, which is my hub name, and then a welcome message.
Yay.
Yay. So
which will be in any telemetry message from an IoT device. Welcome to
that
the
is
IoT
correct.
Show. Love it.
Everybody will know. And then the other data same. So now for a user, they can parse this really easily and identify what they want to do with this data downstream.
I love it. So if people want to learn more, show us back the slide that we had, this AKA link.
Yeah.
So aka.ms/IoTshow/IoTMSGEnrich.
Yes.
Like IoT message enrichment.
Yes.
Ashita, it was a great demo of this new feature of IoT Hub. Hope to see you soon on the show again.
Pleasure. Thank you.
Everyone, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and go onto that AKA link to learn more about IoT Hub message enrichment.